Welcome in this lecture where we will discuss the final topic of the first module of this course. In about 4 video clips, we will discuss the special vehicles. What are they? Well, we have discussed in one of the first lectures the 3 principles in which you can fly. Being lighter than air, pushing air downwards, or pushing something else downwards, as we have discussed. And we've seen mostly the first 2 categories discussed so far. But only by looking at the balloons, airships, and the fixed wing airplanes. But there are many other ways to fly. To push air down, push something else down. But also, if we look a bit further in the future, there are plans for vehicles, most of them actually in this category, which we haven't looked at really. So in this final 4 clips, we will have a look at some of those vehicles and the principles. Well, the first one, as you can see in the figure, are the so-called ground effect vehicles. What are they? What are ground effect vehicles? Well, the principle is comparable with a hovercraft. A hovercraft is sometimes by people who operate it also referred to as flying, but I consider it more sailing actually, but it's floating on a cushion of air. And in that respect, it is very similar to a ground effect vehicle, because in a way, a ground effect vehicle is a normal fixed wing plane, but by flying at a very low altitude, it also floats on a cushion of air. What is the principle behind it? If we consider the standard design of a ground effect aircraft, it's very similar to a fixed wing plane. So we've used our laboratory aircraft here to demonstrate the principle. Every aircraft that generates lift does this by pushing air down. And in this way, it creates a downwash. Well, what happens if you get very close to the ground is that this downwash cannot escape. And in this way, you create this cushion of air. If you want to model it or want to calculate it, there's a very easy way to do this. Because at a ground level, at exactly 0 altitude, the vertical speed of the air has to be 0 because the ground is there. And this means that if we model it by modeling an aircraft flying upside down at the same altitude, but then with a minus sign, we get a symmetric flow. And this is a very easy way to demonstrate in roughly the principle of not allowing any vertical speed at ground level. And this is also a way to visualize why a ground effect generates extra lift. Because you basically feel this virtual downwash of the other aircraft flying imaginary under ground level upside down. The downwash of this aircraft is basically extra air that moves you up and generates extra lift. And if you get very close to the ground, this can amount to a substantial increase in lift. You see on the slide here that's even for some aircraft up to 40%. And this is of course also the effect that you notice when you land an aircraft. You will see during the flare when the speed decreases, normally you would have stalled already, but you will continue to fly a bit longer before you actually touch down. So every aircraft, when it touches down, experiences this ground effect in the final meters. Apart from an increase in lift, there's also a reduction of the drag. And that is because the vortices around the tips are also distorted by the ground, and they have less of a drag effect. You get extra lift for free, and there's less wing vortices, and these effects together create less drag. These effects of an increase in lift and a reduction of drag are only noticed at very low altitudes, and a rough order of magnitude is that the altitude has to be less than the span of the aircraft. When you're flying at the altitude of the span of the aircraft, it's generally negligible, but when you get below it, it becomes noticeable, which means it's really at the very last meters. Well, this ground effect can be experienced with every aircraft, but you could also specifically design aircraft to utilize this effect, which will never get higher. And this way you can save weight and make smaller wings and still move at the same speed and of course save fuel. There has been a complete program by the Russians looking at seaplanes, at ground effect planes, which of course need a flat surface. That's why they are very useful above water when the weather is good. And they developed a complete program with really some huge vehicles in the 60s and 70s. We see here on the figure that there were also plans to continue beyond the 80s, actually, beyond into the 90s. But the program actually was cancelled after the two huge vehicles, which are sometimes referred to as the Caspian Sea Monsters. We have some actual old footage of these experiments by the Russians. Here you see a number of those vehicles. They were built for military purposes. The idea was that you could, without the enemy noticing you via the radar, approach the other side of the Caspian Sea, approach the coast without being noticed. And this, of course, is a huge advantage. And also, it's a very efficient way to move transports, to transport troops across such a large water surface. Before it has actually reached the speed, it's just like a normal seaplane. And here you see one with launchers for surprise attack on countries on the other side of the Caspian Sea. These vehicles are no longer active, most of them. They were experimental, and they never really made it into large numbers, into operational status. They are still present. You can still see them along the borders of the Caspian Sea. And though we cannot go there right now, there's another way to actually show them to you by using Google Maps. So here we see Google Maps with on the left side the Black Sea and on the right side the Caspian Sea. And there are only a few ports actually on the western side of the Caspian Sea. So if we zoom in to some of them, here for instance we see Kaspiansk, and there, this was really very close, zoom a bit out. Okay, let's go back to the coast. And here we already have the, I think let's move them into the center, zoom in a little bit more. Here we see one of those ground effect vehicles, probably on display. I don't know if it's possible to approach them, but here you see it lying in the harbor. One of these, currently not, as far as I know, not longer operational. Ground effect vehicles of this experimental program of the Russians. Maybe it's a nice homework exercise, or actually homework break, to try and find a few more yourself. I think there are more along the coast, and they are visible on Google Maps. The fact that these Russian vehicles are no longer operational doesn't mean that the ground effect vehicle is completely dead. In fact, there are a number of people, a number of industries trying to develop a new ground effect vehicle because of its huge efficiency. And here we see, for instance, the vehicle which is called the UH-19XRW by Universal Hovercraft. And they have a combination of a hovercraft and ground effect vehicle in this vehicle to be used for personal transport. This is the first type of special vehicles, but there are more. You will see them in the next clip.